go again. Oh. Back one there. Well, it works.
Hi guys, I got a request on my Patreon account from Pip to do a rubber band powered aeroplane made from cardboard. Now, few issues around that. Not quite sure how much of it's got to be made from cardboard. Like, do we make the propeller as well? And the other thing is, I'm not too keen on going out flying anything at the moment, not with the lockdown and that sort of thing. So I've come up with a compromise. I'm going to make a cardboard aeroplane, basically from this piece of cardboard packaging that pizza came in. I've got a bit of wooden dowel here that I bought for something completely different. Actually, it was the wrong size, but never mind. So I've got that. I've got some leftover plywood from one of those wooden clip together kits. So I'm going to make a wooden fuselage, cardboard wings, tail and fin or rudder. Probably do the propeller from cardboard as well. That will limit it quite severely. It's not going to be very powerful. But I've also been doing zip wire stuff recently. So what I'm going to do is make this cardboard aeroplane and put it on a zip wire so it flies the length of my garden or across my garden on a zip line. So it probably won't fly on its own, but on the zip wire it should go from end to end and it'll all be contained within my garden, so I've got no worries about it flying away. So, say Patreon and Pip, and the design I'm going to make. So we're going to have a fuselage with a fin and a tail, and then at the front end we'll have a section like that sticking up with the wing on it like that, and the propeller there. And the reason for doing it like that is we'll have the zip wire will be either on a bit of drinking straw across the top there and across the top of the tail, something like that, so the zip wire goes straight through, and it's got to be high enough up there so the propeller doesn't hit the zip wire. So that's what I got in my head. That's the general plan, something like that, so we can have a aeroplane that flies across the garden but it's retained, stays safe, and we should be able to fly it backwards and forwards. And because it won't need much power, because it won't be trying to actually take off and fly, the fact that I'm going to try and use a cardboard propeller or a card propeller cut from that shouldn't be too much of an issue. If it does get too much of an issue, I do have some plastic propellers from other kits. I have these, a couple of these kits tucked away that are foam. I think that's where that propeller comes from, one of these kits. I've got videos of me flying these, making these. But they turn up in charity shops occasionally. Anyway, that's what I'm going to do. So, first thing I'm going to do is find a suitable piece of wood on here that I can use to make the that bit that sticks up there. Just out of interest, Just bearing in mind I might want to use that, but I reckon if I cut across there and across there, I can use that section. Right, so that's my stick up bit. So I'll stick that on there. I'm just sort of generalising the depth, the lengths and distances here from what I've got. I mean, that is 90 millimetres high. I'll have it sticking out about 50 millimetres at the front there. So this isn't actually going to really fly. So I reckon about here somewhere. I did think of using one of my bamboo skewers, but they're only about that long. It would still work, but it would look a bit short. So, right, we need to glue that onto there somewhere. I think super glue will do it. If it doesn't, I've got craft glue. In fact, it might have to be craft glue, because I think my super glue is stuck solid. Yeah, it's stuck. How about if I, because I've used it and the top is stuck on. If I do that. Yeah, now it's going to leak out. It's either that or throw it away, because you just can't get the top off. So that should do for today. Because you could hot glue it if you've got a hot glue gun. I find super glue is pretty good at sticking my fingers together, but quite often when I do something like this, it just fails. Yeah, my fingers stuck to it. All right. Just put a little bit more on there. What you can do, I'll go and get it. You can sprinkle baking powder on it. This is my baking powder for my hobby stuff. And that builds up a thicker join. Bit like concrete. I'm overdoing this. I do scrape all this back and put it back in the jar. So don't panic. I've had people advise me to do it various ways so I don't waste so much. Well, I don't waste any of it. All that gets brushed back in a minute. Right, so there we go, that's our whatever we want to call that bit. Right, remember there's no top on that. Go. So we've done that bit. Now we want a tail. And wings. Oh, I suppose I could have been clever and cut that into a bit of a curve to give us some airfoil shape. Can we do that now without it all falling apart? Oh, actually, no, I'm not going to bother. If we were going to try and make this fly, I would have done that. But because it's going to be on the zip wire, I can glue a tube or something on top of it if I leave it flat. But then again, with a fold up the middle, the wings are stronger. Yeah, we will do that. I'll just give it a little bit of a... You could do a nice curve, but I'm just going to do a little bit of a fold at the front. So, wings are going to be about that wide. Might be best to cut this open first. Funny, isn't it? If you wanted it to stay together, it'd fall apart. Right, that's a bit better, so you can see what we're doing. So wings. Let's just get the general dimensions first, and then we'll worry about how we're going to make it look in a minute. Make sure you're cutting on a cutting board. On top of each other. Hold them tight. We'll have a little bit of a sweep back on them. The scissors. Still holding it tight together. Did I say a sweep back? I actually meant a sweep forwards. Never mind. So that's going to be our wings. He's just found a little bug for me on the strawberries. We'll have a look at that with the microscope later. A green one. All right, that fold. There. To go. Oh, I just realised what I did. I meant to put those face to face. Alright, okay, I've actually done this backwards. Because I meant to have the colour on the top of both of them. No, I haven't. That's alright, that's right. I've just got to fold that one the opposite way. Panic for a minute there. It because the idea of putting a fold into it, yes, it gives it a bit of an airfoil shape, but it also stiffens it a bit. So when we glue that on there, it might pay to put a joining piece underneath, but that'll be a little bit stronger. We had a piece there, didn't we? That piece. So if we glue that underneath, yeah, we'll do that. Should we use that super glue again? Give it a bit of extra strength on the join. Right, I'll glue that on. Do remember, if you're using super glue like this, you are going to stick your fingers together if you're not careful. If you do stick your fingers together, don't panic. Just work on it gently and it will come off again. Right, might need to strengthen that a little bit. Do this with one hand. Left-handed. Okay, so that's our wing. Mustn't forget we've got to put something on here to attach the propeller to. That's going to have to stick down a bit. Bit of bent wire or another little bit of that plywood coming down and a tube on the bottom of it. Yeah, that might do the job. Now, if you were doing this again for a proper rubber band powered aeroplane, you might want to cut that at an angle so that your propeller is pointing downwards, a bit of down thrust. But I'm just going to glue that on there straight. go again. Oh, before we do that, let's open this so we're ready this time. Bless you, Nanny. This also makes the super glue go off quicker. Okay, so that's for attaching the tube for the propeller. And if we got a nice shaped one, we could even make a hook for the back. Doesn't need to be too hooky. That bit there might do the job. That bit. Trying to picture this in my head. Now that's a nice looking piece. Too many choices. Sorry guys, I'm thinking as I'm doing this, I'm just trying to choose the right shape. I think I'm thinking too hard. Let's just take that. Yeah, I think that'll do. Just about there somewhere. You don't want it to go all the way to the back. Well, actually it won't matter on this plane that we're building. Again, a real one. If you have the rubber going all the way to the back, that affects the centre of gravity. Right, so that's that bit done. Tail. Tail and fin. Tail, yeah, something like that. Centre line, so we know where the middle is. Right, if we make it 24 long, then the middle will be on 12. Let's make it an interesting shape. Right, so that's our tail. Be a good idea if we can get it to line up with the wing. Just make sure we can see where the centre line is. That level. That looks about right. And a rudder. I have it in mind to make the rudder as close as possible, the same height as that. How high was that? 9 centimetres. Pencil's broken. there. Okay. Don't want to have a bit of a like that for the tail. Stick that one there. And that's going to be the awkward bit that doesn't want to sit down for me. I think we're almost there. Nope. Oh dear, oh dear. Gonna have to add some strengthener again. I think we've just about used up all that super glue, which is good, because otherwise it was going to go in the bin anyway, because I couldn't get the top off. So that basically is our aeroplane. So I need to get a bit of tubing to go on there. For the bearing for the propeller or the plastic tube, I've got one of these. These are those ones that are destroying the world because they're plastic. I've got a pack of them that I've kept specifically for this particular type of job. So we need it to be just a bit longer than that. Like that. We will need a bent paper clip, so we'll just check the paper clip will go through there. It should do, it has every other time I've done this sort of thing. There we go. So our propeller's gonna spin on that. So we need to attach that to there. Now you could glue it. I'm going to wrap some cotton around it and glue it. Right, there we are. Cotton to hold it in place. And we'll start another super glue tube. You're supposed to undo that, push that in that way to break the seal there. And I find when I do that, I tend to squeeze it and it all shoots out over my fingers. So instead of that, I'll leave that in place. I've got a nice long pin there. I can push straight down in, and that goes through for me. The wing touching the camera, haven't I? Right, that should hold that in place. Put the top back on there. If we're lucky, it won't glue itself in place. Right, I need a bead and we need to make a propeller. I could just stick that one on there, but we'll see if we can make one from cardboard just to keep it all neat and tidy. How big? I'm going to make it the width of my ruler. I was allowing for it to be that big. I'll do that. I might want another piece and stick them together. Just make them a little bit stronger if it's double thickness. Leak out around the edges a bit. I'll give that a few seconds to dry. The super glue does actually make it stiffer as well. And you probably feel it heats up as well. Right, what length have we got? How big was that one? That was about 17 and a half. So if we go 17, pencil wasn't broken, we draw a line. Instead of that, I'll score it. So I need a line in the middle there somewhere. And corner to corner there. Okay, so that should be the centre, which should be. It's 17 overall. 8.5 or 85, which it is. That's good. So we need to make a hole there. I've got my hole making tool. And for our propeller, we need to twist it. So that's going to twist that way around, and that's going to twist that way around. I don't want to tear it like that, that's not good. I have to put a bit of glue on that now. glue. So cardboard is far from ideal for this sort of thing. I'm just looking at that. I think the reason I got R written on that is it's the one I used for reverse, as in pusher rather than the puller. We'll see how that goes. I'm going to stick that on there. A bead in between to give it a bit of friction-free movement. Right. So it'd be nice if that was straight. So that's going to go through there like that. And then we can just bend that round for now. Again, if you were doing this for a proper aeroplane, you'd want that to freewheel as well, but I'm not going to worry about that. Have I got a bead? Plastic bead. So, plastic bead to reduce the friction. Put that through there. And then we need a hook on the end of there. Something like that. That'll probably do. For our purpose, that'll probably do. Some rubber bands. Oh, mustn't forget, we've got to glue some tubes on the top here, yeah? I should think drinking straw would do. Yeah. Certainly at the back end, we can just tape it in place. Front end, I don't know whether taping it will work, because it's probably going to come loose, isn't it? Might have to glue it as well. That appears to be actually sticking. Didn't expect that. That plastic's probably been dissolved by the super glue. That's why it's sticking. All right, well, if that's sticking, that's what we want. So we now need a bit of line to go through there so we can fly it. You could have made, using the bent paper clips, you could have made a bent paper clip pigtail there, and then you wouldn't have to feed the line through. You could actually wind it onto the pigtail. Didn't think of that. Still, we'll see if this works. Got some kite string here. I've just pushed it through there. Push it through the other one. Okay, so that's to support our aeroplane. We'll go and see if that propeller is any good out in the garden. Right, we're set up on a zip wire across the garden. I've actually got it on a slightly upward facing zip wire. I have no idea how easily it's going to slide. That feels a little bit tight to me. We might end up having to put pulleys on there. Still, we'll see if that propeller can do anything. That rather sad looking propeller. Yeah, I could have done better there, I think. Okay, is it going to move? No, not at all. That is far too tight on there. That's disappointing. I do have pulleys, so we might end up with pulleys. Might end up having to put a proper propeller on there as well, but I'd like to get it to go with a rubbish propeller. Those are cheap rubber bands as well, so they'll probably snap. Not a hope. That is far too tight. That's just not... It's not going to do it on there. I could shorten them. Performance. Do we go for pulleys? I have some pulleys that I printed for a 3D project a while ago. Bent paper clips.
gonna sit over there. Go for the principle first. That's a bit smoother. Right, what's the chances? None. Not getting enough power from that propeller, are we? We could cheat and try going downhill. Yeah, that more or less goes on its own. In fact, it wasn't even on the pulley then. Okay, on the Pulleys. Yeah. Well, it sort of works. We could do a lot to make that better.
I think a decent propeller. Just trying to force it a bit. Go again. Back on there. Well, it works. Right, I've put that other propeller on. I had the proper one, so we'll see how it goes with that. I've turned it around so it tries to go uphill. Okay. Are we ready? Oh, didn't quite make it up the hill. That was a definite improvement, wasn't it? Just for comparison, we will turn it round and go the other way. I think that'll be enough. Okay, all in place. So there we go, it works. In fact, I don't even think that pulley on the back is necessary. I think it just needs to sit there. So there we go, a cardboard, or at least cardboard wing, cardboard tail, rubber band powered aeroplane on a zip wire. For Pip. it's just occurred to me, somebody's bound to ask, would it actually fly? I haven't designed it to fly. I could just throw it and see if it glides. It glides downwards. That bent the propeller quite significantly. Give it a bit of up elevator. Yeah, it does almost fly. So I hadn't intended it to fly. It was supposed to be zip wire. Because what I was saying was I'd need down thrust on it if it was going to be a proper one. It hasn't got down thrust, which is why it was doing that. You need to cut that, point it downwards, and then that will help to make it fly. Possibly take off the up elevator. Well, I've got to say, I'm surprised. That is just about flying. Didn't do anything with the propeller on it, but... Right, one last throw. Glider 2.